Hey Rams, it's Isaiah here, ready for another productive Ram week. Radford High School's junior senior prom, A Night to Remember Under the Stars, is on Saturday, March 28th at the Hyatt Regency Waikiki Resort and Spa from 5:30 to 10 p.m. Forms have been distributed during advisory on Wednesday, December 18th. Additional forms are available in Mr. Baba's room 163 or Mr. E.T.'s room in 282. On January 13th, forms had to be completed and filled out and signed in order to purchase bids. Come to room 163 to purchase your bids. If you have any questions, please see Mr. Baba or Mr. E.T. Do not wait. Prom will sell out fast, so hope to see you there so you won't be square. And you know what else is square? Your cap. Like your cap and gown. Senior Luau is on Friday, February 21st at Radford High School. There is authentic Hawaiian food, desserts, games, and over $500 worth in giveaway prizes, games, hula, fire knife dancing, and a private concert by Kaloi Kai. Senior Luau bids are now on sale in room 163, Mr. Baba's. Come by to grab your form, submit your payment and form to Mr. Baba's room again to reserve your spot. Mahalo, and see you there.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself,
are you Dr. Doolittle?
So Robert Downey Jr. has a new movie called Doolittle. It was bad, but it's good nonetheless. So it's a goofy movie. It relies more on comedy than telling a story. There is a message in the movie, but it's just overshadowed by the most borderline childish comedy. But it did get a laugh out of me, which was bad, but you know, it was fun nonetheless. It's dumb and cute at the same time, but Robert Downey Jr. pulling a bagpipe out of a dragon's butt and having the dragon fart on him, like a good full minute of the dragon farting, is just borderline the barrel comedic cheap card you can put in a comedic movie. The voice cast is a little wasted, but it does pull through. John Cena playing a polar bear named Yoshi was probably my favorite character because he says, bro, gotcha, bro. And that was a fun character to watch. From a psychopathic tiger with mother issues and a scared gorilla seeking confidence, Doolittle is a good movie for the five-year-olds out there. See you later.
And now, the moment you've been waiting for, our lunch. Tuna salad sandwich. Fresh veggie sticks and dressing, seasoned oven fries, fresh fruit of the day, and 100% fruit slushy and milk, as always. It's just milk. It's just milk. That's all for today, Rams. I'm Isaiah. Hope you have a Ram canoogling day.
Trivia. Which of these European universities is the oldest? University of Bologna, Cambridge, Oxford, or Salamanca? Italy's University of Bologna was founded in 1088, making it the oldest university in the Western world. There are a lot of good jobs in the United States that do not require a four-year college degree, but for decades, studies have indicated that people with college degrees usually earn more than people without them, at least on average. What might surprise you is that it may not matter so much where that degree comes from. Even though elite schools like Princeton, Harvard, Columbia, MIT, and Yale frequently top the list of America's best colleges, there are a lot of millionaires and some billionaires who started out at community college, and some who never finished a college degree.
The vast majority of American schools actually accept well over 50% of their applicants, but there is a tier that are highly selective that take fewer than 20%, 10%, in some cases, fewer than 6% of their applicants, and what parents and kids will do to get into those schools is practically heroic. There's a question that no one addresses, which is, are those graduates of elite schools who go on to great success, is that a reflection of what happened to them at those elite schools, or is it a reflection of a lifetime of privilege that invariably led to admission into and attendance at one of those elite schools?
In my experience in business, there is very little difference, if any, between a very high-priced business education and what's available for a lot less money. I learned just as much at the University of Nebraska as I did at Wharton.
You hear a lot of successful people who attended elite schools say you don't need to. They don't notice some appreciable difference in the quality of people who came from, say, a large public school with a fairly high acceptance rate and someone who came from a very elite private college with a low acceptance rate.
If somebody graduated from a great university, that may be an indication that they will be capable of great things, but it's not necessarily the case.
No. We've turned the college admissions process into this sort of shopping mall where we view certain things as the Neiman Marcus, others as the JCPenney, and God forbid you end up in the Target across the street. But what matters much, much more than where you go to school, and this is, there's no doubt about this, is what you do when you get to that school.
Can we get